I think it's important that when you have your vascular ring surgery done, you go to a center that is well-informed and has a large experience in this. Just because you have a vascular ring divided, if you don't address all the other necessary important components, then you can still have symptoms. So we like to take all of that into account when considering surgery, looking at the esophagus and airway and other effects. And so hopefully the implications of the surgery, if you have it done with us, is you will see minimal long-term problems thereafter. Occasionally, you'll still have some early dysphagia if that's one of your common symptoms, but generally that resolves over relatively short order. And hopefully the implications of surgery will be that you're cured in the end. What is the post-operative course for patients with vascular ring surgery? So it can vary quite a bit. I'd say typically though, if it's a standard, pretty straightforward vascular ring operation, frequently patients are extubated or the breathing tube is removed in the operating room or within the ICU within the first few hours of surgery. And the patients are then up, moving around the same day or certainly the day after. We like to mobilize these patients early, and they're frequently a part of our so-called ERAS program, or Enhanced Recovery After Surgery program, to help facilitate this. So frequently, the breathing tube comes out early, we mobilize early, and then we go from the ICU to the ward in relatively short order. For some of the more complicated reconstructive surgeries, we may require the breathing tube to be in for 24 to 48 hours before removing it, which will lengthen the ICU stay by a day or two. But again, we try to minimize that to allow patients to get up and back on their feet early.
Follow-up care depends on several circumstances. First of all is the type of operation they underwent and the degree of need for immediate postoperative surveillance or follow-up. Some may be fairly mild and such that we follow up initially virtually or via phone call and then maybe space them out to others that we may need to see you in clinic a little more frequently. Some of that depends if you have any other underlying conditions such as heart conditions or other issues that may require a little more close follow-up. But in general, again, the theme is that follow-up is usually fairly tailored to the individual patient. Our hope would be that all children who were active before would be able to go back to play sports. Depending on the type of the operation, some patients need a few weeks of recovery, limiting heavy activities or contact sports, but usually it's a very short-lived limitation, and hopefully after the recovery period, most patients will be back to their baseline or even in a better situation than they were before, such that their stamina and exercise capacity and ability to breathe and eat would be better if that was the main issue before.
We're working on being innovative and advancing the field. And some examples of the ways we're doing that are developing databases where we can manage outcomes of our patients and developing ways to use technology like 3D modeling to inform our surgical approaches. And then finally, we pride ourselves on continuity of care, because here at Boston Children's, you want to make sure your child is cared for from the time that we call you for your second opinion intake call, through your time here as an inpatient, and then finally after discharge postoperatively, as well as anything in between.